यस यू आर ऑडिबल, देयर इज नो
परफेक्ट. ओके परफेक्ट, लेट्स स्टार्ट देन. आई विल शेयर माय स्क्रीन. ओके Puneet, I'm not able to share my screen.
Let me make you host, then you will be able.
Okay.
You are host now. Now you can share. हेलो
यस सर.
हेलो
यस सर.
यस यस.
कैन यू हियर मी?
यस
यस सर, वी कैन हियर यू.
ओके सो डू यू गाइस हैव एनी ऑप्शन अदर देन जियोलॉजी एंड फॉरेस्ट्री?
नो सर, माय ऑप्शनल इज जियोलॉजी एंड फॉरेस्ट्री इटसेल्फ.
ओके ओके सो आई वाज टॉकिंग फॉर लाइक 2 मिनट्स और समथिंग, बट डिड यू हियर ऑल दैट और नॉट?
No, sir. For 2 minutes, I didn't hear anything.
Okay. I realized it. Okay, welcome, guys, to SOMP Mentorship Program for IFS 2020. My name is Ratnesh, and I'll be taking this orientation session. After this, also, for next 45 days, we'll be working together until IFS mains. All right. So, basically, in IFS mains, there are 6 papers, 2 papers of 2 optionals each. So there are like 4 papers of optionals and then 1 GK and 1 English. Yeah, we already have got timetable for IFS. 28th is when we are starting with general English and general knowledge. So we have like maybe 1 month and some 10 days or something, right? And then if you take last week for revising and for English and GK, so for geology and forestry, we have like somewhat more than 1 month. That is like covering, if you have new optionals, both new optionals, it is somewhat tight schedule, but it is still doable. Most, like many people do it. Do you guys have options other than geology and forestry? Like somebody has agriculture or something? Hello?
I'm not aware, sir. Mine is geology and forestry, and the other participant is not speaking, I believe.
So mine is also geology and forestry, sir.
Okay, Divya, that is you, right?
Yes, sir. It's me, sir.
Okay. So there are other people also. I am not sure if they want to actively participate. But anyway, so this program is mainly for geology and forestry, that will focus on geology. In geology, have you guys gone through syllabus?
No, not yet, sir.
Okay. So this is the syllabus for geology, right? There are basically two books that we will refer to in the program for geology. One is Principles of Engineering Geology. This is from K.M. Bangar. And the other one is Textbook of Geology, G.P. Mahapatra. Most of the topics we will cover from these books, and other topics which are important from exam point of view and which are not covered in these books, you guys can like contact me and I will provide you short notes on that. There is no need to refer to other books since, see, we really are already tight on schedule, right? So we don't have that luxury of going through multiple books, looking for sources, then enriching our answers, right? Most of the people that are writing IFS, they are also tight on schedule. So they are also not going to refer to other books. It's competition is always relative, right? Like if you write better than the guys next than you, then you get selected automatically, no matter what he writes, right? If he just leaves his copy blank and then you write some answer and then your answer is already better than what actually has not written anything, so you already get selected, right? So it's all relative. So idea is we'll just stick to these two books in geology, and then whatever topics you don't find here, that I will provide. You guys can like, we will be taking weekly calls, and then you guys can tell me what all the topic you are struggling with, and then I'll give you a short note, right? So this is how we'll cover geology. I'll go through syllabus in next few minutes, right? And then for forestry, there's this one book. It is like Rambaan, right? We call it Rambaan. It's like show sort. This book covers most of the topics of IFS. Forestry optional, right? So if we just stick through this book and then few topics we can refer to here and there, right? That also I can provide if you guys are not able to find. And okay, so first we'll go through syllabus and then we'll see the typical study plan, right? So this is the syllabus for geology. Like I said, we will refer to K.M. Bangar and G.P. Mahapatra mostly, you know, for all the topics. There are two papers, paper one and paper two, like similar to civils. Each paper has two sections, section A and section B, right? So basically we have four sections, two sections in geology and two sections in paper one and two sections in paper two. Similar in forestry, two sections in paper one and two sections in paper two. Right. Any questions until now?
No, sir.
For guys who are like joining now, or those who have mixed first few minutes, do you guys have any questions, or you are like coping up? Hello. Hi. I'm talking.
Sir, no questions, sir.
Okay. Okay, Divya. So first topic of paper one, section A, general geology. It is mostly related to geography, but it has a tinge of geology also, right? Somewhat. So most of these topics, they are very easy to cover if we just go through the basic geography plus some additional concepts. Similarly, geomorphology also, if we have covered plus one, plus two books, then it is not difficult to comprehend, right? What starts new is remote sensing, this part, aerial photograph, their interpretation and limitations, electromagnetic spectrum, orbiting satellite and sensor system. Some of these topics we have also studied in GS, like what are geostationary satellites, what are polar satellites, GPS system, our regional GPS, which is, you know, IRNSS system. The specific topic here is applications of remote sensing in geology. This is important also, and GIS system and its applications. Indian remote sensing satellites, of course, this also, they sometimes ask questions. The core geology in paper one, section A, starts from structural geology. Some of the topics in structural geology, they are somewhat difficult to comprehend, but then we will focus mostly on questions, mostly on topics which are like pet favorite for questions, right? Because in the minimum time we want to draw maximum benefit, right? We have tight end schedule, but we also want to score marks. So we'll see what are the important topics on structural geology. There are some core topics which we have to study just to understand the later on topics, right? So it's like stress strain ellipsoid, stress strain, and this stress strain relationship, deformed rocks, then fault and fault classification and their mechanics, right? And then faults, lineation, foliation, joints and faults and unconformities. These are very important topics and they are somewhat easy to understand also. So we'll, and they are pet favorite for making questions also. So we'll focus our efforts only on these topics. Introduction to petrophysics, this is a very small topic. Ek do baar question aaya, only once or twice they have asked questions on this topic. So since it's very small, we can cover it in like, if we study it for like 20 minutes or something, right? Maybe 30 minutes or something, half an hour, you can prepare this. Since it's only an introduction to entirely different topic. Like there is a book on petrophysics, but we just need to study only introduction. Also in geology, in IFS, they mostly ask direct questions. Like in petrophysics, they once asked, write a short note on petrophysics. So if you have just studied for like half an hour, what is petrophysics and what it is all about, you can still fetch some marks writing that. Then in section B, paper one, these are core geology topics. One is paleontology and other one is stratigraphy. Paleontology is all about the study of fossils. Okay. Like how we study fossils and then how we draw conclusions from that study about the evolution in the history of Earth. So there are in mega fossils and micro fossils, UPSC is mostly concerned about microfossils. So we'll focus all our efforts only on microfossils, right? Megafossils, mostly if we read definitions, that should do it, right?
Bhai, there are some trolls, one from Russian name, just remove him, remove him.
Some Russian guys there.
Yeah, trolls are there. Yeah, it is fine now.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry, guys.
It happens.
Okay.
And so, others, and please mute your audio. Whenever sir will ask you to ask any question, only then unmute. Otherwise, mute your audio. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Puneet. So we were talking about microfossils. So in megafossils and microfossils, we focus all our efforts, not most of efforts, but specifically all our efforts on microfossils only. In microfossils, we need to study mode of preservation, different kind of microfossils, and then there are application in geology, like in petroleum exploration, paleoclimatic studies, all these things. There is a short note on this that I'll provide, ki microfossils ko hum kaise use karte hain, right? Then there are some microorganisms, like not actually microorganisms, there are some bigger organisms also that we need to study from evolutionary point of view, right? Cephalopoda, trilobita. Trilobita is very important from exam perspective also. Brachiopoda, Echinoidea, Anthozoa. These are, we'll study their morphology and their evolutionary trend. And then we'll find out from the evolutionary trend, what are the evolutionary phases of Earth's history. Because like, you know, whatever is our climate, that is how organisms evolve, right? The climate affects all of us. So in past geology, like past Earth's history, climate change, we have studied ice ages, right? So all this climate, it affected organisms and their evolutionary trend. So this is what we're going to study in paleontology. And then we'll study evolutionary trend in hominidae. This is human, and then equidae, which is horse, and proboscidae, it is elephant. Shivalic fauna and Gondwana flora is again very important topic. Then we come to stratigraphy. Stratigraphy is actually how the layers on the Earth's crust and interior, you know, how they are arranged and like what is their lithology, or kaise like how they got arranged because of climate and other changes. So from stratigraphy also we got to know the evolutionary history of Earth. There are some boundary problems that we need to study, Cambrian, Pre-Cambrian, Permian, Triassic. So if you find any of these names somewhat horrific, you know, कुछ डर लग रहा होगा अगर इन नामों को देख के, so please don't get worried because they are somewhat technical, but once we get hold of this, no, they are like easy to understand. Since it is our first glance on the syllabus, so we might be like get scared of these very difficult terms. And then we study tectonic framework of India. In this, we study the stratigraphy of stratigraphy and geology of India. And then we study evolution of Himalayas, how Himalayas evolved over a period of time. Then the last. Sorry, somebody saying something? Okay. And the last topic in paper one is hydrogeology and engineering geology. This is somewhat easy to comprehend. Mostly questions are directly like they will ask what is saltwater intrusion now and how it affects the groundwater level, types of wells. Only this topic, this is somewhat technical, drainage basin morphometry. Otherwise, these topics are very easy. Porosity, permeability, hydraulic conductivity, transmittivity, transmissivity. This is mostly definitions and some concepts related to definition, right? Exploration of groundwater, groundwater recharge, rainwater harvesting, we study in GS also. So this is hydrology, geology is mostly very easy topics. And they are all covered in Bhangar also. And then we come to engineering geology, engineering property of wreck, rock, geological investigation for dams, tunnels, and bridges. This is very important topic. UPSC mostly asked one questions from either dams or tunnels or bridges. Rock as construction material, landslides, and earthquake resistant structures. These are also somewhat important. Landslides we need to study in another topic in paper two also. So we'll cover this extensively here. So this is about paper one of geology. In paper one, if I have to put it like in two lines, so basically core geology part is structural geology, and then paleontology, and then stratigraphy. Since this section B, it has two parts, which is core geology, paleontology, and stratigraphy. So in order to maximize our marks, our strategy should be to attempt three from this section. General geology, geomorphology, and remote sensing, and then structural geology, because these initial two sections, general geology and geomorphology, they are very easy to comprehend and also easy to remember and write. Diagrams are also comparatively very easy. And then we write two questions from section B. Mostly one we'll get from this, hydrogeology and engineering geology, which is like very easy to comprehend and remember. And then one question we right from paleontology and stratigraphy, right? Any questions, guys? This completes our overview of syllabus of paper one of geology. Okay.
Sir, I missed the initial part on sources. Like, what are the sources we need to refer? If you could kindly.
Yeah. I think, okay. Repeat. I think. You joined somewhat late. We already discussed this, but again, I'll show you.
Oh, sir, if I can, contact you later.
These are two books that we are going to refer in geology. This is called K.M. Bhangar, Principles of Engineering Geology, and this is G.B. Mahapatra, Textbook of Geology. These books cover most of the topics.
Sure, thank you. Right?
Not all the topics. For some topics which are important from exam point of view and you don't find in these books, that I can provide you ready-made short notes, right? You don't have to go to, there are multiple books. Of course, geology is very vast subject, but I don't recommend that you go through all the books or through one book for just one topic, because we don't have that. Okay, so then we continue to paper two. This is geology paper two. In this, all the topics of section one and section two, section A and section B, all the topics, they're like we see in paper one, some topics they are not like core geology, hai na? Like geomorphology, general geology, this we already studied in geography somewhat. But if we see in paper two, all the topics mostly mineralogy, igneous and metamorphic petrology, sedimentology, economic geology, mining geology, and geochemistry, all these topics, they are somewhat new to us. Only some topics in environmental geology, which is pollution of groundwater, environmental protective legislations, coastal erosion, landslide, natural hazards, earthquake, volcanic activity, from like this is from disaster management point of view. So this is topic that we we have some feeling of these topics. Otherwise, most of the topics are new. In paper 2, section A, this is core geology, mineralogy. In mineralogy, we have three parts. One is optical mineralogy, in which we study X-ray crystallography, crystal defects, petrological microscope, and their accessories. And then double diffraction, extinction angle, birefringence, twinning, dispersion. And we have crystallography, another topic. In crystallography, we study crystal systems, classes of symmetry, crystallographic notation, and projection diagram. Then we have physical mineralogy, in which we study mostly silicate minerals, right? This silicate mineral group, this is very, and classification of silicates, structural classification. This is very important topic in mineralogy from exam point of view. In crystallography also, in classes of symmetry, there are 7 classes. This is somewhat difficult topic because we need to, you know, imagine the 3D models of crystal systems. But then not all the 7 are important. There are 2-3 crystal systems which are important. So we can just, if we just remember those, maybe probably we'll find one of them in the paper. Maybe 3 if we remember, and then we'll out of 3, we'll definitely find one in the paper. So we just write that and make diagrams. And then we come to igneous and metamorphic petrology. Igneous and metamorphic petrology, we already know what is igneous rocks and metamorphic rocks, I'm assuming, right? So it's all about how igneous rocks are formed and how metamorphic rocks are formed, what is their process, and then what are their effects on surrounding rocks, right? And their classification. So basically petrography and petrogenesis of these rocks. In this, we also study the crystallization system. Deccan volcanic province, this is about the Deccan traps. We study this in stratigraphy also. So this is common topic in both the... Sorry? Hello. Okay. So then we come to metamorphic petrology. Metamorphic petrology, we study phase rules, ACF, AKF diagrams. Some of these topics you won't find in Bhangar, especially in metamorphic petrology. So if you don't find any topic and it is from important from exam point of view, that I'll provide some ready-made short notes. If we just go through that 1 or 2 page notes, and then we can cover the topic from exam point of view. Like if 10 marker is asked or 15 marker is asked, we'll have sufficient content to write that answer. Okay. And then we come to sedimentology. Out of the 3 petrologies, igneous, metamorphic, and sedimentology is somewhat very easy. So this is what this covers, is how sediment rocks are formed, what are their petrography and their effects on environment, right? Like surrounding. Also their structures, what are the structures that sedimentary rocks form? And then we study heavy minerals and their significance, right? Then we come to paper 2, section B, economic geology. In whole paper 2, like paper 2, section B, economic geology and mining geology, what our idea is that we want to study the economic use of minerals, how we prospect them, how we find them, how we mine them, what are the methods available, and then what are their uses, right? And then in India, specifically from Indian point of view, right? Where are their deposits and what are the stratigraphy of these deposits? This is what we study in section B, paper 2, economic geology and mining geology. There is also a numerical ask from mining geology that is around, maybe sometimes they ask in 8 markers, right? So it's very easy. If we do 2-3 of them, then we definitely we'll cover this thing, right? In economic geology, the last three topics, national maritime, national mineral policy, conservation, utilization of mineral resources, and maritime mineral resources, and law of the seas. These three topics are very easy. Like, you don't have to put any effort in these topics. If we study these topics for 1 hour each, and then we are done with it. The core topics are here. Or controls of ore localization, ore textures and structures, and geology of important deposits, Indian deposits, right? Also, in this thing, there are so many deposits are given, right? Copper, gold, iron, lead, zinc, manganese, titanium, uranium. Out of these, we'll study all, of course, but we'll put more focus on topics which are more important from exam point of view. Then we come to geochemistry and environmental geology. Geochemistry, geochemistry is comparatively easy, and from exam point of view, there are not many questions asked from geochemistry. Mostly in section V, they're going to ask many questions from economic geology. Some questions, maybe one or two questions from mining geology, and one question from geochemistry, and another one from, or maybe two maximum, from environmental geology. So in, like we saw in paper one, our strategy in paper two should be to cover three questions from section B, since this is not core geology, right? This is somewhat easy. We just have to remember the facts in this, right? Where our deposits are found, what are their stratigraphy. In paper two, section A, these topics, crystallography, optical mineralogy, igneous and metamorphic petrology, this we have to remember the facts as well as we have to understand also. So we'll try to attempt two questions from this section and three from section B. So that is how we intend to cover geology and write it. Yeah, this covers the geology part of it. Any questions you guys have? I hope I'm not boring you guys. Hello.
No questions.
Okay. So we come to forestry. In forestry, like I said, we'll cover all the topics from one book, which is Manikandan and Prabhu, Indian Forestry, right? In forestry, there are two papers, paper one, paper two. Both papers have two sections. In paper one, section A, silviculture. This is core forestry. All the concepts of forestry are here. The practical concepts of forestry, right? So silviculture general, this is general principles of silviculture, and then silviculture system. This is practice of silviculture. Silviculture is all about how we grow trees and for the economic use of them, right? Because we want to draw maximum benefit, economic benefit from the forest, not just other benefits. So the silviculture is all about them, maximizing our benefit from growing of trees. And then this paper one, section A, is mostly all about silviculture. Here we study silviculture, the practice of silviculture. Then we study silviculture in two specific areas, mangrove and coal desert. This is very small topic three, right? But this is like very high return topic. We invest some amount of time in this, and then the number of times question asked from this topic is relatively more. And then we have silviculture of trees. In this also, if you see, there are so many trees given. Nilotica, acacia. I think there are some 14, 15 trees given here. But out of these, there are some important trees that are pet favorite of what is important from exam point of view. Butea monosperma. And then we come to section B. Hi, can you guys hear me? It says my internet connection is unstable. Okay, we come to section agroforestry, social forestry, joint forest management, tribology. This is very general part of it, like how we involve community in the benefit of our forest and maximizing the benefits from the forest, right? So this is all about JFM, joint forest management, social forestry and urban forestry. This is very general topic. And then we come to forest soils. Some of this part we already cover in Sankar IAS environment, forest soils, like nitrogen, carbon cycles, VAM, soil erosion. Only the important topics here are saline and alkaline soils, waterlogged soils, wastelands, how we recover them. So this is what we study here. This is also not very technical, very generic topics are these. Then watershed management. We come to environment conservation and biodiversity. This topic, pollution, environment legislation, environment impact assessment, this is already covered in the whole topic. Number four is covered in Sankar IAS. So we'll just refer here. And then mostly I've already done this. Then we come to this topic, tree improvement and seed technology. This is somewhat technical and we intend to put more effort on this topic because this involves concepts of botany, like progeny test, tree improvement, and what are the selection techniques, genetic testing, programming, breeding, and all these, right? Genetic concepts basically from botany. So this is somewhat technical also. We put more efforts on this topic. Otherwise, environmental conservation, forest soils, JFM, these are very generic topics. If we just give one read or one, maybe two reads, then we are pro in this. Then we come to forestry paper 2. Paper 2 also, like paper 1 has two sections, section A and section B. Section A has forest management systems. This is all about how we're going to, the types of management of forest and how we draw benefits from them, like growing stock, regulation of yield, management of forest plantations, site-specific planning, village forest committees. And then we come to forest working plan. Forest working plan, this is also not very big chapter. It's like maybe 5 pages or something, if I remember right. And mostly they ask, like every alternate year, they ask one question from this topic. So this is very high written topic, forest working plan. Not very technical. It's mostly descriptive and generic topic. Then we come to forest mensuration and remote sensing. Remote sensing part of this, we have already covered in geology. So mostly what we cover in geology, that suffice here. I mean, you don't have to study anything other than what we study in geology. Maybe if you, it's forestry specific applications we study in forestry, like how are we going to use remote sensing in forestry. In forest mensuration, we'll mainly focus this. There are some mathematical concepts here. Some formulas are there. So we'll focus our efforts there, like form factor, volume estimation, increment, CAI and MAI, right? These are also very pet topic, sampling methods. Then we come to surveying and forest engineering. This is not very, like they call it forest engineering, but it is very basic. Like what are the kinds of bridges, what are the designing bridges and constructing them. So it's not very typical engineering. It's kind of somewhat part of civil, but very generic. Basic principles of forest engineering, building materials and construction, general principles, right? In construction and design of timber bridges. Then we come to paper 2, section B, forest ecology and ethnobotany. Forest ecology, basically if we see biotech and abiotic component, forest community concept, vegetation concept, ecological success and climax. Some of these topics we have already studied in Sankar IAS. Physiology and stress environment, forest types in India. What we'll study here is ethnobotany mainly. Ethnobotany, not very important from exam point of view, like maybe in 5 years, once in 5 years, there's one question out of it. So it's very small topic, maybe like 3 or 4 pages read. So we'll study this mainly application part of it, role of ethnobotany in Indian systems of medicine. Right? Factors affecting action and toxicity in drug plants and their chemical constituents. Maybe they can ask one question from this year, since there's a lot of this thing now. In coronavirus, this thing we have increase our use of Indian system of medicines, especially Ayurveda and all. So probably, maybe they can ask use of ethnobotany in this year. Next topic is forest resources and utilization. This is all about what are the types of resources that we get forest and what are the benefits and how we utilize them, right? So basically, there are some non-timber forest produce. One is timber, of course, that we grow forest for. Other one is other non-timber forest produce, which is gums, resins, fibers, oil seeds, charcoal, cell, selak, lek, katha, bidi, the processing, right? And then from timber resources, what we get is pulpwood, ply, fiberwood, their manufacture, how we make particle boards, plywood manufacturing. And then in the processing of wood, we also study some techniques, which is seasoning, and then solar dehumidification, steam heating, electrical cleans. This is how we process wood, the timber that we get from forest, right? So that we want to, if you want to preserve it for longer time, then we need to process it. So this is what we're going to study in this topic. Then we come to forest protection and wildlife biology. This topic is all about what are the dangers, like what are the external agents that affect forest in negative way, and then how we can protect forest from these external agents, which can be biotic or abiotic, which is destructive agencies like insects, pests, grazing, or you know, all these things. And then how we control these chemical and biological controls. Wildlife biology, this is very generic topic, and we mostly have studied some of it in Sankar IAS. Then we come to forest economics and legislation. From exam point of view, forest economics, they rarely ask questions. Their main focus is from forest legislations. So they mostly, we ask from Indian Forest Policy, 1894, 1952, 1990, National Forest Policy of 1988. Then we have another forest policy, right? The latest one. And then people's involvement, JFM, again, we have to study here, right? We have already studied JFM in paper one. So we'll just continue that thing only. Involvement of women, decentralization, and then forest public administration. In this, we study the forest laws, Wildlife Protection Act, Forest Conservation Act, Indian Forest Act, and their amendments. So basically, this is mostly the laws related to forests that we study here. This is important from exam point of view also. Mostly they ask either a policy or an act every year. Yeah, so this is what shortly covers the syllabus of forestry and geology. For those guys who missed, like who joined us late, these are the three books that we're going to put our more focus on. These two books are for geology, Principles of Engineering Geology and Textbook of Geology. And then this is for forestry, Indian forestry, Manikandan and Prabhu. Okay. So now we'll see what should be our typical study plan. See, we have very limited time, right? Starting tomorrow, we have how many weeks? 5 weeks. If we keep last week for revision and preparing English and GK, right? So we just have 5 weeks for studying everything and then revising it and then writing answers. So we are very tight on schedule. Our focus should be to cover easy topics twice and thrice. And then what are the difficult topics? We'll cover once and we'll revise it again twice. And then that too, what are the important topics in from exam for exam point of view, right? From the difficult chapters, the important topics we'll revise, right? So the one which is larger front, right? These are somewhat difficult topics. And the ones which are in a smaller font, they are comparatively simpler topics like sedimentology, hydrogeology, engineering geology, and general geology. These are somewhat simple. While stratigraphy and silviculture is from forestry. These are somewhat difficult topics. So our idea is to keep two difficult topics in 1 week and three simpler topics in that week, right? So first week, we'll focus on stratigraphy and silviculture systems. And then second week, we'll go to igneous and metamorphic petrology and tree improvement. In simpler topics, we can study geomorphology and remote sensing, JFM and soils. Then comes next week. This is the date written, right? Like from 1st of February to 7th of February. This is the week. Then here we can put our focus on mineralogy and economic geology. These are somewhat important from exam point of view, also somewhat difficult. And mining geology, geochemistry, environmental geology, forest legislation, protection and utilization. The forestry part of it is very generic. Most of our effort, maybe 70% of it, should be on mineralogy and economic geology. Then we come to next week, which is from 8th to 14th of February. Here we put more focus on paleontology, structural geology, and forest management. The working plan, surveying, and forest management part of it is somewhat easy to handle. Then we come to 15th to 21st of February. So in this, these are very small topics, utilization, protection, and legislations. We have already covered this in 1st to 7th also, but we again do somewhat like revision of it if something is remaining from earlier weeks, and then we put whole week for revision. Yeah. And then in the next week from 22nd to 27th, in that week, 2-3 days we have to study GK, right? And maybe one and a half day for English. So that's how, like, this is typical study plan, but you can always amend it and make it according to your needs, right? Whatever suits you. Yeah. So that was from me. Any questions you guys have got? We can take questions for geology, for forestry, or for any general questions also, guys. Abhishek, you have been with us since we started, right? Abhishek Bharti.
Yes, sir. No questions, sir.
Okay. Okay. Anyone else? Okay, guys, so this was from my side. If you guys want to add anything or ask anything, then we can, you know, talk about that. Otherwise, we can just follow this typical study plan or whatever you can make according to your needs and how you want to approach the exam. And then we can work on that. Yeah, but we have to start tomorrow itself, because we already are very short on time. Do you guys agree or not, at least on this, that we are short on time and then we need to study more intensively?
So I am definitely short on time because I was on leave for my sales mains for a long time, and now I'll have to join my office from tomorrow. So I'm definitely short on time. I'll have very little time for study.
Okay. How about others?
Yes, sir. There is very short of time and we will start from tomorrow itself, sir.
Okay. Perfect. ठीक है. अगर आप लोगों को कुछ नहीं पूछना है तो I think I'm done. But we can always connect again, right? Like whenever you have something to ask, you can always message me and then I'll make sure that I reply probably by the, you know, latest by next day or something, if you message me in the late night hours. Yeah. Puneet, you there?
How can we contact you, sir?
This SOMP, no, they'll share. I think they are doing all this thing, no? They are the main point
yes.
of contact.
Hello, guys. Those who are going to join the course will give you the contact of sir. Otherwise, for on geology group, you can join and ask your doubts to the sir. Okay.
Yeah.